We understand how tedious it can be to see which repositories have recent WIPs or which ones to open next. That's why we're thrilled to introduce GitKraken Client 9.0 and transform your development workflow. So first major update, there are now two kinds of GitKraken workspaces, local and cloud. If you're unfamiliar with workspaces, here's a quick overview from Justin, our director of product.
So what are workspaces? The simplest explanation is that workspaces are just groups of repositories. When you're working on multiple repos constantly, just having them in one view where you can see which branches are checked out and what work you have in progress across all of your repos makes keeping track of your work much easier every day.
With 9.0, users may now create local workspaces to group repositories on your machine. To create a local workspace, navigate to the Workspace tab in the upper left of the app and click on New Workspace. Choose the Local Workspace option and set the name, description, and then browse to select repos. Once created, you'll see all your selected local repos grouped together with information about which branch is currently checked out. Click on any repo name to open it as a tab. Select multiple repos to perform a multi-fetch, or use your selection to create a cloud workspace. That's right, you can create a cloud workspace using your local workspace. This gives you more visibility into your pull requests and issues, plus makes it easier to share with teams. Use this menu option in the top left to select Create Cloud Workspace from Local to bring up the same menu, or you can just click this big button right here. Then just configure the name, description, and click to create cloud workspace. We encourage you to try out local workspaces for organizing your repos and finding what to work on next. And hey, let us know what you think. All right, now speaking of cloud workspaces, we have some notable updates there too. First, we have Focus View, which was previously called the Overview. With this release, you may toggle columns on or off from this gear in the top left corner. Now, if you have a team workspace, you'll notice a few updates too. The team overview is now the team view, and this will show you all the pull requests and issues associated with the repos in your workspace. And similar to the focus view, you may now toggle columns on or off from this gear in the top left corner. All of these workspace updates combined should help you sail through your issues, your branches, and your pull requests, hopefully supercharging your workflow. Okay, next, we're excited to introduce GitKraken Insights, which is available in preview in version 9.0. GitKraken Insights measures how fast pull requests are merged into your repositories. But why is it so important to monitor metrics like cycle time and throughput?
So I think there's an underlying principle that exists here. The longer your code changes are not merged into main branch or whatever target branch you're using, the more difficult and the more complicated your workflow is going to become in order to get them in, especially when that PR becomes stale or longer than, 7 days or 14 days.
To enable GitKraken Insights, you'll first need to open a cloud workspace and then navigate to the pull request section. Once the connection is complete, return to the pull request section in your cloud workspace to see metrics like cycle time, throughput, merge rate, and many more. Use the icon here to get more information about what each of these metrics mean, and hopefully you can use this data to find out where you can make improvements in your development workflow. GitKraken Insights is currently in preview, and we'd love to hear your feedback as you start to use it with you or your team. Next, we have a number of UI and UX improvements. First, you'll notice that the UI has been refreshed to reduce visual noise. Over in the left panel, the icons have been realigned, and the left panel performance should now have a smoother feel when resizing sections. In the commit graph, you will now see a ghost branch when you hover over a commit. This will show you the closest branch that contains that commit. And double-clicking that ghost branch will check out the head of the referenced branch. Additionally, when you hover over a branch, the app will highlight commits referenced by that branch. All of these settings can be configured from Preferences, UI Customization. Okay, now it's time to do a rapid fire for some other improvements we think you'll enjoy. First, you can now solo branches directly from the context menu of branches in the graph, which hides all other branches and commits. It's pretty handy. If you're a Windows user, the menu bar and context menus will now match the GitKraken client theme. And finally, LFS users should see improvement in operations like cherry pick, revert commit, and more. All right, we have even more details about improvements and fixes in our release notes, which we've linked in the description below. From all of us at GitKraken, we hope you stay legendary.